Hi, and welcome to the Downtown Framingham Implementation Plan Open House. My name is Eric Halverson, and I am with the Metropolitan Area Planning Council. We are the regional planning agency for the Greater Boston region and have been working with the town of Framingham to develop a specific plan with specific actions the town can take to make downtown Framingham a more vibrant, active, walkable economic center. But don't take my word for it. Here's Town Manager Robert Halpin to share his thoughts on downtown Framingham.
Good morning. I'm here at the Cushing Memorial Park, a short walking distance from downtown Framingham's commuter rail station. And I'm here to talk about a wonderful event which the Metropolitan Area Planning Council is hosting on November 18th to explore a development vision for downtown Framingham. And the reason I mention the commuter rail station is the commuter rail station and other transportation assets are really at the heart of a very unique development opportunity that I see for our downtown area. Usually a commuter rail station will see a fairly high density of residential development that springs up and is attractive to a young professional commuting population that looks for an alternative to an automobile. So about a year and a half ago, we began a process here in Framingham of evaluating what it is about downtown Framingham that's not seen this type of transit-oriented development occur around the commuter rail station. We've learned some things. One is that there's a need for greater residential density within walking distance of the train station. Our zoning density tends to be suburban, as you would expect in what is largely a suburban community. But downtown Framingham is urban in its character. So we need to look at increasing density as a way of creating critical mass to draw investment and create high-density residential mixed-use development within walking distance of the train station. We've also heard that the parking requirement, also suburban in its character, creates an added burden for developers seeking to develop residential structures in downtown Framingham. And then lastly, we've heard a great need for flexibility among developers to choose the right mixture of residential, retail, and yes, maybe even some office in downtown Framingham. So this opportunity on the 18th at Nevins Hall is a great opportunity for you, a stakeholder in downtown Framingham, to build on what we've been learning about this opportunity and share your ideas about what will make Framingham a vibrant, urban, diverse, multicultural center that can really be a hub of economic activity in the Metro West region.
As Bob mentioned in the video, downtown Framingham has a huge asset that many other downtowns in our region don't have, a commuter rail station. The map shows the location of the downtown commuter rail station in proximity to the rest of the downtown. The first yellow ring around the commuter rail station represents what's walkable in roughly 5 to 8 minutes from the station. As you can see, much of the core of downtown is quite walkable in a relatively short amount of time. The second ring is what's walkable in about 10 to 12 minutes from the station. Again, many parts of the outer ring of downtown are accessible by walking. This idea of bringing housing, jobs, businesses, and amenities like parks and plazas and civic uses within a short walking distance to public transportation is known as transit-oriented development, or TOD. TOD is a concept that is extremely popular with municipalities, developers, and the younger and older generations who want access to downtown environments and transit without having to rely on driving everywhere. Downtown Framingham is poised to take advantage of the assets it has to create a transit-oriented center. In 2009, the town of Framingham developed a vision plan specifically for downtown that included three key goals that would help to lead to the success of creating a more active economic center in downtown. The three large goals coming out of the study that would guide activity in the downtown were: 1. Revitalize and renovate existing buildings in the downtown to encourage greater use of the historic building stock. 2. Encourage development that would fill in vacant lots and surface parking lots in key locations in the downtown. 3. Increase the amount of pedestrian activity on key corridors like Waverly Street and Concord Street to help increase businesses and take advantage of the proximity to public transportation options. Unfortunately, the Great Recession created a downturn in the economy that slowed down development not only in Framingham, but across the United States. There were brighter days ahead after 2009, and now demographic and economic shifts in demand and market preferences for housing have switched to favor downtowns and places that have access to public transportation. Downtown Framingham is well situated to take advantage of the renewed interest in downtown transit accessible locations by residents and businesses and developers. Downtown Framingham has a number of great amenities to support downtown living, which include a fabric of historic buildings, a number of art and cultural assets, a very diverse set of restaurants and businesses, and nearby open spaces like Farm Pond, and access to a robust network of regional walking and biking trails. Not to mention direct access to the commuter rail and Metro West Regional Transit Authority bus service. All of these things combined create a structure that could help support a rebirth in downtown. In our discussions with downtown business owners and residents, we did hear some feedback on what downtown is missing. People commented that downtown Framingham is not like downtown Natick. It's not like downtown Lowell. It's not like downtown Marlborough. So we asked ourselves, what is it about those other places that sets them apart and makes them stand out in people's minds as great places to spend time and money? Here are a few elements that we think make a downtown successful. How buildings are designed, their interaction with the sidewalk, and the experience you have walking in a downtown shape your perception of the place that you're in. Successful downtowns are well lit with pedestrian scale lighting along the sidewalk. There are comfortable places to sit along the sidewalk, and outdoor seating for restaurants and shops. The sidewalk is wide enough to accommodate at least two people walking side by side with room for street trees, benches, and trash cans. Active first-floor uses like shops, restaurants, bars, galleries with large picture windows that allow pedestrians to see inside. And finally, upper stories on buildings are usually occupied with residential housing units or office space, which adds height to the building, frames the street, and brings more people to downtown to support local businesses. A key component to making a downtown vibrant is understanding that the pedestrian must come first. While we understand that is often a difficult choice to make, pedestrian safety and making walking easy in a downtown can encourage people to park once rather than drive around looking for parking because walking does not feel safe. The downtown also needs to have the right mix of uses to attract a variety of people to the center. The businesses should be diverse and serve a wide range of people, but not lose the local flavor that may set it apart from other downtowns. Redevelopment and infill opportunities are key to reclaiming the fabric of downtown. Filling in the holes creates economic opportunity, supports the local tax base, and provides a continuous and active street frontage for pedestrians walking along the sidewalk. Downtown Framingham has a number of key infill sites along major corridors. Managing your parking assets and making sure they are easy to use, easy to find, and available will help reduce customer frustration and reduce traffic from vehicles circulating to find parking spaces. Downtown Framingham has over 2,500 parking spaces in garages and on surface lots. Our field data showed that during the hours of 12 to 4 p.m. on the weekday, only about 50% of the total available parking in downtown was being used. At the same time, we've heard frustrations about parking availability from residents and businesses. One idea could be to have better signage, maybe a more visible parking map, and sharing parking among buildings and businesses that might have different parking demands depending on the hours and times of the day. Programming of space is key to the life of a downtown. Having activities at various times of the day and different days of the week will draw people to downtown. Programming ideas could include farmers markets, art displays, outdoor movies, outdoor festivals, outdoor games, food trucks, pop-up markets, and more. Downtown Framingham is already doing some of these things, but finding the right mix of events that will attract a wide range of people is important. Downtown Framingham has had enough visioning, and it's time for some action to make some things happen. Our project team, in partnership with the town, has been analyzing the key challenges and action steps the town could take to help create the environment for a successful downtown. Building on the vision from 2009, we have looked at three specific elements that we think are critical to positive outcomes. The first is to find out if there's actually a demand in the downtown for new housing and businesses, and what kind. A team from RKG Associates and LDS Consulting have put together a market study looking at demand in downtown Framingham. You can find out more from them at station number 4. The second piece is getting the rules and regulations for development right in the downtown. This is known as zoning. These rules set the stage for what can and cannot be built, and rules for how it will be built. Visit with the Cecil Group and MAPC at stations 5 and 6 to find out more about development and zoning in the downtown. Finally, the transportation network and public amenities need to be designed and function in a way that's supportive of a downtown environment. Visit with GPI at station number 7 to look at their assessment of downtown and what infrastructure investments are likely needed. Taking all three of these pieces together and setting the table with some carrots or incentives for the development community could be the key to seeing investment in the downtown. The people that we've met with and talked to over the last couple months have been excited about the possibilities in downtown. They see it as a hip, cool place with great transportation options that could one day be the hub of Metro West. They feel like it's a place ripe for change, but doing that in a way that preserves the cultural assets and diversity of the people and businesses. The future could include a gritty feel that's natural and not forced, and one that supports the arts. Many pieces are in place. It's now about bringing everyone together around a collective action and making it happen. The town and project team have not discounted the challenges that exist within downtown. We have heard many comments already about traffic, parking, the ability to attract the right developers, the train tracks, and the perceptions around public safety. That's part of the reason why we're here tonight, to listen to your feedback and to ask you a few key questions that will help us get a better understanding of supporting for these concepts for downtown. We hope to share the information we've collected and analyzed, but more importantly, hear about what excites you. What do you see as the opportunities, and how can we solve the challenges together to make downtown the place everyone wants to live, work, shop, and play? We have set up several stations around the room with information for you to review and questions we hope you will help us with. There is staff all around the room who are ready to assist and answer any questions. Thank you so much for spending part of your evening with us, and we look forward to talking to you and hearing your thoughts.